S-Chan presents educational video lectures as per the AICTE curriculum. Difficult concepts made easy. Study anywhere, anytime.
Hello students, in this part of the video we'll discuss about sentence construction, sentence structure, and we'll discuss more about what are simple, complex and compound sentences. It's important to know that because these are the technicalities of the language which you need to understand in order to understand the language well. Welcome to S-Chand Academy. I'm Dr. Vidushi Bhardwaj. To know more about the subject, word formation and vocabulary building, you may refer to this book by CAS Publications. The link has been given below. So why the knowledge of good grammar for a language understanding is important? Because language is something which you will know only if you know the technicalities of the language. So technicalities comes from grammar, it comes from sentence structure, and that is how you'll understand the basic writing and speaking skills also. A sentence means a set of words that is complete in itself, typically containing a subject and a predicate. It conveys a statement, question, exclamation, or command. It consists of a main clause and sometimes more or one or more subordinate clauses. Now, what are these main clauses and subordinate clauses? We'll discuss about this. Basic word order is subject, verb, and object. Like in English, we say, I drink water. So, I drink water, three words making one sentence. So, we have different types of sentences. We have simple sentences, we have compound sentence, we have complex sentence, and we have compound complex sentence. A simple sentence contains one independent clause. Now, what is an independent clause that we'll discuss? That means it's one subject, follow verb phrase. It expresses a single idea. Examples, I am happy. Or Robert does not eat meat. My brother and I went to the mall last night. So this new laptop computer has already crashed twice. So the simple sentences are the ones which convey the meaning in a simple form. Compound sentence has two independent clauses joined by a linking word which is a conjunction, and, but, or, so, yet, however. So these are some of the examples of the linking words which are used in compound sentences so that they are joined by independent clauses. Each independent clause could be a sentence by itself. It can be independent in itself, but we connect them with a linking word. For example, we can say, I am happy, but my kids are always complaining. So this but becomes a connector or a linking word. Robert does not eat meat, so Barbara made a special vegetarian dish for him. So becomes a connecting word or a linking word here. My brother and I went to the mall last night, but we did not buy anything. Now this but is the connector. This new laptop computer has already crashed twice, and I have no idea why, and is a connecting word. Let's talk about complex sentences now. A complex sentence has one independent clause and one or more dependent clauses. So, as the name itself suggests, dependent and independent. Independent clause, not dependent upon anything, while dependent clause is the one which is not independent in meaning. So, a dependent clause cannot be a complete sentence by itself. That's very important to remember. For example, when I say I'm happy even though I don't make much money, it is a complex sentence. Robert, a friend I have known since high school, does not eat meat. After getting home from work, my brother and I went to the mall last night. This new laptop computer which I brought yesterday has already crashed twice. In these particular sentences, why do we call them complex sentences? Is because there is only one independent clause. I am happy. This is an independent meaning, you know, sentence in itself. Similarly, Robert does not eat meat. Robert does not eat meat. This is an independent clause. While the rest of the part, if you see independently, is not independent in itself. So it is a dependent clause. Similarly, after getting home from work, my brother and I went to the mall last night. So after getting home from work, is a dependent clause. While my brother and I went to the mall last night is an independent sentence in itself, which makes meaning in itself. This new laptop computer which I brought yesterday has already crashed twice. The part from which till yesterday is a dependent clause. While if you take these parts independently, this new laptop computer has already crashed twice. It's an independent clause which carries an independent meaning of itself. Now let's move ahead. Okay, let's take some examples of compound complex sentences. First of all, what is a compound complex sentence? That is all we need to understand. A compound complex sentence contains three or more clauses, two independent clauses, and at least one dependent clause. For example, if I say I am happy even though I don't make much money, but my kids are always complaining since we cannot afford to buy the newest toys. This is a long sentence. So independent clause here is I'm happy. So it's an independent sentence. My kids are always complaining. This also carries an independent meaning in itself. While dependent clause here is even though I don't make much money, because it starts with even, it does not carry an independent meaning in itself. Since we cannot afford to buy the newest toys, when we started the sentence with since, it becomes a dependent clause. So what I'm trying to say here is that the understanding of compound complex sentence and all these, you know, kinds of sentences is important to understand how do we frame sentences, technically speaking, in a right and correct manner. Let us take one more example and then we can proceed. For example, this new laptop computer which I bought yesterday has already crashed twice. However, I have no idea why. Now, let us see the independent clauses here. This new laptop computer has already crashed twice. We can see it's not dependent upon any other thing. I have no idea why. It's also an independent clause, while the dependent clauses which I bought yesterday. And the linking word is however. So we understand that how these, you know, independent clauses are converted into dependent clauses by the way of certain usage of certain words like since, however, similarly, even, though. These are the words which are used initially at the beginning of the sentence to make it a dependent clause out of an independent clause. So let us now understand the uses of phrases and clauses in sentence. So there are many different types of phrases and clauses. We've been talking about dependent clause, independent clause, but what are they actually? Technically speaking, what does it mean? The first step to identify the different types is to understand the difference between a phrase and a clause. Technically, a phrase is a related group of words, a word that work together as a unit, but they do not have a subject and a verb. For example, when I say the boy in the bus is a noun phrase, will be running is a verb phrase, in the kitchen is a prepositional phrase, very quickly is an adverb phrase, Martha and Jan is a noun phrase. How do we decide what kind of a phrase it is? Is by the usage of the part of speech in the phrase itself. So for example, boy in the bus, boy is a noun, will be running, running is a verb, in the kitchen, in is a preposition, very quickly, quickly it's an adverb, Martha and Jan, they are both nouns. So that is how we decide what kind of a phrase it is. Now, clause is a group of words that does have both a subject and a verb. Some clauses are independent, like we just discussed in the previous slides, meaning they express a complete thought in itself, while an independent clause is the same as a complete sentence. Some clauses are dependent. All clauses are not independent, some are dependent, which means that they cannot stand alone independently. They have a subject and a verb, but they do not express a complete thought. So another word for dependent clause is subordinate clause. Let's move ahead with the definitions and some examples. So dependent clause is a group of words that contains a subject and a verb, but does not express a complete thought, as we already discussed. It cannot be a sentence. It cannot be considered a sentence. A dependent clause is marked by a dependent marker word. So let us take an example. When Jim studied in the sweet shop for his chemistry quiz, what happened when he studied? We do not know. The thought is incomplete. So it becomes a dependent clause. While an independent clause is a group of words that contains a subject and a verb and expresses a complete thought. An independent clause is a sentence in itself. So for example, Jim studied in the sweet shop for his chemistry quiz. We can hardly wait to see our favorite artist. It is very important to brush your teeth every day. All these sentences, which are independent clauses, they have a subject and a verb in itself, and they are independent clauses, so they become full-fledged sentences which convey a good meaning in itself. Now, moving ahead, this is how we have finished with the sentence construction and sentence structure. Let us talk about the importance of punctuation in grammar. Why the correct usage, the right usage of punctuation marks is important, so that you achieve effectiveness in your language and you write effectively. What is a punctuation? Punctuation can be defined as the marks such as full stop, comma, brackets used in writing to separate sentences and their elements and to clarify meaning. Without the usage of punctuation correctly, you may even create blunders in your language. That's very important to understand. So the usage of punctuation marks is something which we need to understand in order to achieve effectiveness in language. Use of wrong punctuation mark or even wrong placement of mark can change or alter the meaning of the sentence entirely. So, for example, let us talk about the usage of comma. When the sentence is let us eat, comma, daddy, and the next one is let us eat daddy. In the second sentence, it seems as if we are talking about daddy as the one whom we are going to eat. And in the first sentence, the emphasis is on eating, not daddy. So, a comma changes the meaning of the sentence entirely. In the first sentence, daddy is being called for dinner. While in the second sentence, daddy himself has become an item to be eaten. So, omission of comma in this case has converted the first sentence to complete trash, which does not make sense. So, types of punctuation, there are different types of punctuation. We all need to understand that each punctuation mark is important. We cannot undermine the importance of any punctuation mark here. We have a full stop, we have a comma, we have a semicolon, we have a colon, we have an apostrophe, we have hyphen, we have dash, brackets, inverted commas, exclamation mark, question mark, and bullet points. Technically speaking, if we understand the usage of punctuation marks correctly, we can use the language effectively, especially in writing. And when we achieve this in writing, automatically we speak correctly as well, because we know where to give pauses and where to make a sentence as a question and not a mere statement. So let us understand where do we put a full stop. And it's the most commonly used punctuation mark in English. And we know how do we use it. Still, we need to understand the relevance. We use a full stop to mark the end of a sentence. That is a complete statement. For example, all their meals arrived at the same time and a full stop. We use a full stop to mark the end of a group of words that does not form a conventional sentence so as to emphasize a statement. For example, it is never acceptable to arrive late, full stop, not under any circumstances. We use full stop in some abbreviations also. Here are the examples, and in website and email addresses. Now, moving ahead, we have comma. So, when do we use a comma? A comma marks a slight break between different parts of a sentence. Wherever we need to show a slight pause or a break, we use a comma. There are several occasions, most importantly being four occasions, common occasions where commas are necessary. Using comma in lists, the flag was red, white, and blue. Using comma in direct speech, example, that's not fair. So, we are putting a comma here. And then she said, using comma to separate clauses, example, as we had already arrived, we were reluctant to wait. So we started with a clause here and then we put a comma. Using comma to mark off parts of a sentence. Her best friend, comma, Eliza, comma, sang for a living. So it is obvious here that using a comma is essential to show some break in a sentence where we need to emphasize the part of the sentence. In part one, we talked about phrases and clauses. We discussed simple, complex, compound and compound complex sentences. In part two, we are going to discuss the punctuation mark and their importance in detail. To know more about the subject, word formation and vocabulary building, you may refer to this book by Kaz Publications. The link has been given below. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon and keep looking for our future updates.
All rights reserved. This video has been prepared for educational purposes only. No part of it may be reproduced or copied without the permission of the copyright holder.